Okay, hello everybody. Welcome back to my channel today, and I'm Kevin. Today we are back to our economic topic, and our topic today is talking about how to stop war. So, let's go to figure out what are we going to talking about today. Let's go. Okay, so to stop war, we have to use the thing that call it the game theory. And this is one of the reasons that why the economists going to study this too. And this is one of the way that to use to predicting how to win a nuclear war. And after the economists going, after they going to predicting how to win a nuclear war, it turned out that we have to winning involve not fighting at all, because it's just one of the country who have the nuclear power using the nuclear weapon. So the other country all of the world will go into the end. And for that, this thing is happened between 1945 and 1991. The relationship between USA and Soviet Union is very, very tense. So partly this is the things that make the relationship become more tense, that the nuclear bomb. And for that, here is where the game theory go in to change the play side. So this is the famous game of the economic who going to start of two sides, that the player will decide that should they going to betray the other player or not. And for that, if the player do not trust the other people, they will going to choose to betray them. And the striking lesson from the game was that if one side doesn't trust the other, the 100% choice is the betrayed. Okay, but so both sides, both countries know that the most logical step for the enemies is to start a surprise nuclear war, which means that they both know that the enemy don't trust them, and the enemy will going to start to have a battle surprise for them. And for that, it's going to come to the end of the world. And when the scientists going to study and try to find out how that both countries can survive from a nuclear attack, so it turned out that they have to build enough bomb to can make the nuclear bomb exploding by hitting it on the sky. And for that, they have to create enough nuclear bomb, more or same as the other side, to can survive after a war. So this is things here is very, very similar and very simple, but it's not just like that. That's why, because both countries don't know how much nuclear powers that the other side have. And for that, this is what describing to make a deterrent. And for that, deterrent took away all of the reason and any incentive to can betray the other and make two sides make a scooper. Cooperate. And for that, this is how the game theory in economic stop the war. But also, there are some way to can stop the war without using game theory too. And the most similar way that the economists believing will work today is using the global trade. So the global trade is the things that, as you know, two countries and the others go into trading with each other. And for that, the global trade bring the country together. So the country who are more trading with each other will go in to have less go to war with the other. Or you can see that the more the country trading with each other, the less likely it's worth going to have a war with the country trading with. But somehow there are something things that stopping somehow there are some economists think that if you are make a line of trading with the country, so if you cutting it, it's going to be very risky because it's not it just look like a messenger without resulting about the actual fighting. But also have some economists believe with the first with the first reason of the global trade, that the country that depend on each other have more to lose from the conflict, which means that they will lose more if they start a war. And for that, going to make the global trade is also good but also bad, because they can make the country be better, can connection with each other, but also it can be a burnish and can be a mission to start a war too. Okay? And okay, this is the end of my video today. Thank you for listening, and I hope you guys will see you on the next video. And now, it's time for me to get up. Bye-bye, and see you next time. Ooh.